Janet?
Well, good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
This is a very good turnout. This is the third stop today. I got an early start. So give yourselves a pat on the back for not only showing up, but actually being here, paying attention, and all the rest of that stuff. First of all, I'm going to shift gears, but most people know, because I've always done this election stuff. How many of you were election judges at poll count winners in the last election? Thank you, thank you, thank you. It makes a difference. We have discovered, anecdotally at least, that when we get Republicans inside the precincts, maybe the law gets followed, kind of a novel concept, you know? A couple questions get asked, like, your ID isn't current, can you get something better? So we need to do better, but actually, Ramsey County, Bansky is very pleased with the turnout, and he would welcome even more Republicans, so we can get you a place, keep that on your back burner for the next election. But I'm going to switch hats, take this one off. And I want you to think about something. Jeff Johnson will cover the RNC stuff. We have split the topic so you don't have to hear it twice. We are going to the second meeting, the second week in April, after our state central meeting. But I want you to think about this. We are a nation of immigrants. We are people whose ancestors came here from over there. And over there was either east or west. It didn't matter. And they came here because they didn't fit over there. They were the wrong tribe, wrong culture, wrong religion, wrong political party. Heck, some of them even had land problems. You know, these Scandinavians, they had no more sons to pass the stuff on to. They said, so you go to America and go find yourself some land to work. That's a Minnesotan trait. But everybody who came here because they didn't fit over there. And when you go someplace that is new, that has been undiscovered, that is raw land, whether it was the first Indians or the latest Europeans, they come down, you take north of Canada, Chile, Argentina, there was nothing here until they arrived, and they brought with them. But think what it took them to survive. It took a physical strength, a mental strength, an emotional strength, and the Europeans brought with them a moral strength. This is who we Americans are. We are doers, we are fixers, we are independent, and we have to pull that trait back out. Because if we don't, we're going to put up with more garbage that's going on in St. Paul by people who think people in this room, including moi, are stupid. We're not stupid, we're actually rather smart. And we have to stop this stuff. But understand, it's just this political party that can do it. The left has gone too far. And so we have to stand up. We got to unite behind every candidate we end up endorsing next year. Even this year, I believe you have a mayor election, I hope, maybe in St. Paul. We have to do that. Because if we don't, there's no place to go. And the Democrats certainly are not going to do it. And you say, Janet, can we turn this stuff around? Alabama went red in 2012 for the first time in 138 years. They were the bluest state in the country, 138 years, but they're all red now. Yeah. North Carolina did it. Wisconsin, we know our neighbor next door did it. Oh, they didn't vote for Romney, but that's another story. But the point is, when we pull together, we actually can make something happen. And that's what I would like you to do. Tweet, tweet. What I would like you to take away from the convention is just to remember that at our core, all of us are doers. All of us have a strength. All of us have something to offer. And we have to do it on this side of the political spectrum because the other side ain't gonna do it. So my wish to you is, let's go for it, get everybody we can get in 2014, and we'll just start turning the state red too. Thank you very much. Have a great convention. Thanks for having me.